And we've got five boxes, five crates. I'm now sorting through them. Some need growing, say like this one, and then there's several with scab, like this one. So I'm keeping them as second, so we'll eat them first. And then there's some really nice ones, like this one, but this one's got a hole in, so it's still going to seconds because it won't keep. But there's others that we'll put in that have still got a bit of scab, but I'll put them in a bag that we keep for longer. So just the fun of sorting them all out. Last year I didn't have the scab, no, nothing at all. But this year it's a bad year for this one's okay, so that will go in my nice. But yeah, it's a bad year for scab. But hey ho, that's the fun of gardening. So as I'm sorting them, I'm bagging them, labeled. This one says seconds, and that one says main nice ones, and then I will store them in the dark somewhere. These are the second, and these are the main ones. I've got one bag already, so let's see what else I've got. So we grew Cara because it's a good potato to grow it for, as it's scab resistant. Not that that has worked for us this year at all. You can see how bad this potato is. I won't be keeping that. We think Desiree, I kept my own seed, and even though you can see a couple here with scab, most of them actually came out okay. So there's no logic, no rhyme or reason. I think it's just a case of growing vegetables. I'm letting these, they're in the boxes to let them dry. I don't want to put them damp in the paper bag, it's more chance of rotting. So it's important to put them dry in your paper bags. I've chosen paper bags because they don't let light in. I've got some Hessian sacks, but they still allow a bit of light in, so they may still go green. I have got them in a dark place, so it should be fine. But I bought some paper bags through Amazon, which was actually Fruit Garden Naturally. I mean, they're not cheap. 10 bags were, I think, about £15, but keeping your potatoes good condition for the winter is well worth it. So we think it's got bad scab because it was a very hard year initially when they started growing. They were under a lot of stress. It was really dry, and they didn't get enough water in the first 6 weeks. I mean, they formed nice sized potatoes, like this one. I mean, they're really nice, but just some of this scab. Some will be fine, but the odd one can, like this one, it's pretty horrendous. So the initial 6 weeks, the plants did actually look under stress, and therefore I think is the reason why they've got bad scab. Still edible, still very nice potato. Would grow them again, like love the colouring, that pinky with cream.